Last week, the double murder trial against Clarence Stiff was stopped in its tracks. His attorney asked for 6 more months to investigate contaminated soil and its possible link to the case. But Clarence Stiff says it's about more than that and spoke exclusively with WLKY News. Our Ann Bowden sat down with Stiff. She joins us now with more, Ann.
Well, Vicki, that contaminated soil was found in the area where Clarence Stiff lived. Last week, a question was raised as to the mental effects that those contaminants could have on someone's mental condition. Clarence Stiff contacted us saying it's not about his mental condition, but possibly a relative related to the case.
By no means am I guilty or was I ever even involved in this situation.
The situation Clarence Stiff is referring to is the shooting deaths of Jason Matthews and Tracy Hernandez 5 months ago. Stiff is charged with both of their murders.
From the very beginning, I wanted to, scream to the whole world, that I had nothing to do with this.
Last Tuesday, Stiff's trial was set to begin, but before the jurors even came into the courtroom, his attorney stopped the proceedings, asking the judge for a 6-month continuance. He explained more investigation needed to be done on the contaminated soil around Stiff's former home. Recently, the EPA confirmed the Park Hill neighborhood near the former Blackleaf pesticide factory had dangerous levels of arsenic, lead, and possible DDT. The question Stiff's attorney raised, could those chemicals affect the mental condition of a person?
I never even knew that was the basis of the continuance. Until I walked in the court, I still was dumbfounded to what was going on.
Stiff said he doesn't believe his attorney, Mike Lemke, is questioning his mental condition at the time of the murders. He says he's innocent. He believes it might be for his sister, who lived in the same Park Hill home as he did for several years and implicated him in the murders to police.
If someone would say that it affected me, she lived there a lot for many more years than I lived there. Since she's been in and out of mental institutions as a child and stuff like that,
Now, we tried to contact attorney Mike Lemke last week and this week. He has not returned our phone calls. Stiff says he lived in the Park Hill area in the mid-90s, and the only problems he's had is continued bouts with bronchitis. He also said if he is found guilty, any mental issue that is discovered may be used in the penalty phase of his trial to allow a lesser sentence. Ann Bowden, WLKY News.